This is episode 113 of the Reading Cove Book Club's podcast. If you're a book lover who may be interested in joining an online book club, please visit our website at thereadingcove.com to learn more about our group. For April 2020, we're discussing Quantum by Patricia Cornwell. So hi, I'm Millenia in Florida.
And I'm Roberta in Georgia.
And Roberta and I are two members of the Reading Cove Book Club here today to discuss our 233rd Cove pick, which is Quantum by Patricia Cornwell. And it was chosen by our very own Roberta.
Yay.
So, what happened to your enthusiasm for Quantum?
Well, most of our listeners or our members know, you know, we pick our books that way ahead of time. And it's not just all my fault, because I listed two other things we could pick from, because every month we have three books to pick from. So, the majority wins on that. I thought it would be a good book. I had gotten a copy of it, you know, as a free copy of it when it first came out. And I thought, oh, well, this is a well-known author. Mm-hmm. And this will be interesting. So, you know, I'll put this in the thing for my pick for the upcoming book. But as other things have happened to me in the distant past, the synopsis and what goes on in the book are not always one and the same. So, yes, it was my pick, but I was not quite as disappointed, but I was a lot more disappointed than I thought I would be.
Mm-hmm.
So, wow. You know, it's one of those things, but sometimes it's good to end up with a book that's kind of disappointing, because then there's, you know, more things to talk about why you were disappointed or just downright didn't like it.
That's right. I think the highest grade we got, because we did the poll and all the votes came in and the average is a C minus from the group. And right. So the highest grade in the poll was a C. And right. I think it got two C's. And then D's, I think Pam was the only F, I'm not mistaken. Right. The highest grade was yours, I think, a B minus.
Right. Well, yeah. I'm changing that now. I after reading other people's things and reflecting on it more, you know, I would lower it to a C minus, and that's being generous.
Wow, really?
I found a few things to like, but overall, I was just sort of real disappointed, but...
Well, that's interesting. So when you first read it, you had like a B minus experience. But then when you thought about it more, it lost a whole grade. So what, yeah, what changed?
It lost a lot more luster to it. Yeah.
Mm. Well, I gave it a D plus, and I'll explain the plus. I'll start with the positive.
Okay.
The reason why I felt the plus was appropriate was because I thought there was a lot to learn in this. It seemed well researched in terms of NASA and, you know, the different government agencies and what goes on. The intricacies felt well researched and authentic. So I appreciated that. And I know our fellow group member, Faith, she still hasn't finished it, I think, but she's probably going to give it a higher grade, maybe. It sounds like, because she said she was really enjoying the science stuff. I think she's probably the only one in the group.
That's okay. We need some diversity of opinion.
Yeah.
You know, even if you read online book reviews, there may be sometimes a lot of 4 and 5 stars, but there's always got to be the one person that gives it one or a did not finish, because everybody has different things they're looking for in their reading. I too appreciated she really, really, really did a lot of research, and that's one reason why it wouldn't have been worse for me, because I could respect all the research she did. And as I had stated in our group, the one character I really appreciated was the mother of these two twins, the mother of Callie and Karma, that she was like a truly good mother, that she loved them unconditionally. It didn't matter what did or didn't happen with them, but that she was an excellent mother, and she was a very nurturing person because she's always trying to look out not just for her family but for other people too.
So I like that.
But some of these other things, like I said, some of these people are saying it was too sciencey. Well, it was nice they had the science, but some of it was just so overwhelming that I think probably why a lot of people gave it a bad review is they just couldn't understand or relate to it. So I think, you know, most of the time they say it's not good to dumb down something, but I think in this case the author could have dumbed it down a little bit.
Because who was the target audience here?
Right, because most of the people that would read her type of books, they wouldn't be quantum physicists or scientists or whatever. Those type of people, they're going to read more scholarly type of material. So exactly. I think she lost sight of who her audience was. She was trying to branch out, and it might have been successful if she had just, you know, made quite a few little tweaks to it. But
yeah, I think it really needed a better edit because I found the writing really choppy. I mean, right from the first page, there were sentence fragments, and sometimes authors do that, you know, as a part of their style and delivery. But this one just it didn't have much cohesion and it didn't flow for me. So pair that with all the science and technical details about stuff, and I'm just, my eyes are glazed over.
At first I thought I was gonna like their thing about being that yellow submarine, because I could understand how that woman was feeling, like all these terrible phobias. I think I would get a little freaked out, and I'm not very phobic about things. But it just drug on too long. You know, it was a good idea, but it drug on. It could have been cut in half
a lot. Exactly.
It would have been better. And, you know, I know she wanted to have another thing to tie up these things, but I think too many threads were just loose. It was just, you know, there was just no closure on hardly anything. The only thing that happened was, they averted this horrible disaster. You know, that was only suspense, like in the last few pages of the book. And you figured, well, they're probably going to have to do something. They can't let this turn into a horrible disaster, because then there wouldn't be anything.
Exactly.
You know, it'd be a tragedy. But there's just too many loose threads. And, you know, I could see why they didn't want to find her sister necessarily, because that could be the next book. But I'm even wondering if her publishers are going to let her have a next book.
But I thought the second book was already out.
I don't know.
Isn't it?
I don't know. I haven't really looked closely enough, but it just seemed like this one was so poorly received, and I didn't see it on any bestseller list. Granted, it came out last fall because I got this book last fall.
So maybe the second one is coming. But I think there's a title and everything for book two.
Maybe they'll have it, but, you know, still, I don't know if it'll do any better. Maybe they already made a contract with her and they had to do it, because a lot of these famous authors, they give them like two or three, you know, book deal on things. And since she's so well known, I don't see how she, you know, the publishers might have done okay, but I just don't see how she would earn too much money on this one since it was so poorly received. But who knows?
And then the Kindle version had like in motion or something, like, because I was listening to the audio and reading the Kindle book, and I mean, it was, you know, there were some graphics or like I forget what they call it, but like some motion picture graphics in the Kindle book.
Oh, really?
First I thought, oh, that's kind of cool, but I just feel like it wasn't used enough. It was like at the beginning of each chapter, and then there was a part with like an explosion. They showed it in a way, but
wow.
Yeah. And I
feel cheated. I didn't know you can't have that in a hardback book like I had.
No, it was pretty cool, but I think it needs work. Like, it's a cool feature to have, but you can tell it's rough. They can improve it. Right. It would have been nice if the narrative wasn't so rambly. I felt like Callie was like so angsty and just almost like a teenager. I felt like in some of her internal rants and just going on and on and on and on and on and on. And I kept thinking, okay, get to the point. Like, okay. Enough already. And for a woman that was so educated, like this overachiever.
Right, this brilliant woman. And, you know, somebody said something about her being on the spectrum, being maybe Asperger's. But mm-hmm. someone that had Asperger's wouldn't be that emotional and angsty. That's the thing. They're going to be more like all one kind of layer of a thing. They're not going to be emotional. They're going to be pretty monotone about their feelings.
Exactly. And she was very whiny and felt like she had verbal diarrhea. She just couldn't shut up. Yeah. It was borderline adolescent to me. So that had some issues identifying with her character, being drawn into her. And then you, again, pair that with all the science and technical stuff and the choppiness, and it just didn't pull me in. And she felt very unreachable to me as a main character.
Yeah. Well, I mean, whether you like the person or don't, but still, yeah, you need to have some kind of feelings towards the main character, especially if you're looking at stuff, like you said, from their point of view. So
yeah, many of the comments from the group, you know, in the discussion echo that. Everybody was yes. just kind of disconnected, and it missed the mark in creating any sense of tension. Like you were saying at the end, oh, you know, trying to avert this. But I felt no tension about it. It just never built that up for me.
Yeah,
so I was just like, oh, whatever, yeah. Who cares?
But I mean, still the same thing as far as, you know, anybody feeling suspense, that was about the only suspense was
you're right.
at the last little bit.
And there was just no sense of urgency and for me in solving the mystery and finding out what happened to Karma. And then I wonder, her name being Karma, was there something deeper with that? Like, yeah. It just seemed weird, strange, a person named Karma.
Yes, most definitely.
And I kind of skimmed a lot. To make it through.
Well, that's understandable. Yeah. Like I said, if it hadn't been a pick, it hadn't been my pick, something like that, you know, even though I got it way back when and they expected a review, it would have been a do not finish for me after about 50 pages if it hadn't been,
oh,
you know,
yeah.
Some of our group that they'll read these books and then they'll put really low grades and I'll think, wow, you know, they made it through.
Yeah.
But that I would very seldom finish a book. It would end up being a did not finish for me rather than that low grade.
Yeah.
Unless it was something that for one reason or another, I you know, had to finish.
Right.
You know, for some other obligation or what have you.
Yeah. So I think our discussion's kind of finished now.
Yes, yes. There weren't as many questions to ask this time, but yeah, we're pretty much all finished now.
Yeah, so unfortunately, this one was a dud from Patricia Cornwell. But no. I know that there are lots of fans in the Cove of her Scarpetta series.
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
So yeah, I mean, yeah, she's been highly popular and had a lot of fans over the years, so it's just very interesting that she tried to branch out and just didn't work, you know. Who knows what was going through her head.
Yeah. So what do you think happened to Karma?
I don't know. You know, I'm thinking she's hiding out somewhere, but I'm not sure. I didn't have a real firm opinion on that.
Yeah. And I just was like, maybe this is somebody's karma.
Like, yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, it could be sort of a metaphor, right?
A metaphor, exactly. So I don't know either. And I certainly would not be reading the next book.
I don't think so. I thought about it, but I don't know. Maybe I can find someone else online that read it and say, hey, you know. Write to
whatever
me directly.
Happened to, yeah.
Tell me what happened with Karma, because I don't want to spend hours reading this book. You have exactly. enough other online booklets. You can find somebody that reads all this stuff, right?
Yeah. And what are the chances that the second book would be a lot better than this one? I mean, I guess it's possible, obviously, but...
Possible, maybe, because maybe, you know, after didn't do well, that maybe her, you know, editor or somebody else got after and said, well, we got to spruce this up a little bit.
Yeah, we got to make this much better, or it's just going to drop like a bomb.
Yeah, I mean, because, you know, they're out the money, especially, you know, right now. That you better be doing something good to either promote your book or whatever, you know, because people just aren't going to buy stuff as much. And, you know, even the libraries can't be buying books right now till they reopen, you know, because they don't have means to do it.
Yeah.
So these people just have to hope for the people that have extra money that can, you know, buy it online or whatever.
Yeah. All right. So I guess that's it.
Yes, I think so.
Okay.
But hopefully next month will be a better month.
So thanks for listening. That's our discussion of Quantum by Patricia Cornwell. And as always, leave us your comments below, share your thoughts if you've read Quantum, and let us know what you think. Stay tuned for our next episode. We will be discussing The Seven Sisters by Lucinda Riley. See you next time. Bye.
Bye.